developing and pilot testing an oropharyngeal dysplasia screening tool for children with cerebral palsy age 4-6 years. Research by Ravihari, MCI, Hettiarachchi, S. The paper will be presented by Ravihari, MCI.
Good morning, everyone. And I'm a speech and language therapist, graduated from Faculty of Medicine, University of Kalania. And my study was developing and pilot testing an oropharyngeal dysphagia screening tool for children with cerebral palsy aged between 4 to 6 years. So as you know, cerebral palsy is a chronic condition due to the results of the central nervous system damage. So according to statistical data, 50% of children with cerebral palsy have feeding problems. Among them, most of the children with cerebral palsy have oropharyngeal dysphagia. Dysphagia is a life-threatening condition, and that is the main cause for death of the children with cerebral palsy. So early identification is really important for that. So for screening assessment is the initial step to the identification of dysphagia. So in Sri Lanka, there is no available screening tool for detect oropharyngeal dysphagia for children with cerebral palsy. And under methodology section, my study design was descriptive cross-sectional study, and study participants were children with cerebral palsy and speech and language therapist. And study instrument was oropharyngeal dysphagia screening protocol, which was developed based on the dysphagia disorder survey. And my sample size was 30 children with cerebral palsy. According to results, as a phase one, I developed my screening protocol with the consultation of expert speech and language therapist. Then I pilot test this screening tool with the expert speech and language therapist, and as a phase three, I identified test retest reliability and inter-rater reliability. Under the test retest reliability, there was no significant difference between each other, and inter-rater reliability also, there was no significant difference between each other. According to conclusion, the oropharyngeal dysphagia screening tool was low cost, easily administer in clinical settings for speech and language therapists to identify oropharyngeal dysphagia. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you for the presentation. The paper is now open for discussion.
You had said that it is easy to administer.
Yes.
How did you come to that conclusion from your study method?
Because I did with this my expert speech and language therapist, we administered both together, and we tested, and we get only 5 minutes, not get more than 5 minutes to administer this assessment. This is a screening tool. It's a it gets few minutes for conduct.
Could the nurses be trained on this technique? Is it safe for nurses to be trained?
Yes, they can use this screening tool for assess dysphagia, but speech and language therapists are specializing for the assess dysphagia patients' dysphagia. So this is I mainly focusing on for speech and language therapists.
Did you check for the validity data with any other tools?
Yes, I assess content validity only with the consultation of speech and language therapist. I get their comments, and based on their comments, I develop my screening tool.
Thank you.
Yes, thank you.
Let's thank the speaker for that excellent presentation.